protege of the Hollywood director George Lucas, under his guidance, to be the highest quality, unenhanced sound available today. We've been here a little over 8 years now. And 5 months of it, I was standing here waiting for people to come in. And you were at home, quarantined. So welcome back. We have a great show for you tonight. I want to mention that we don't do this type of thing very often, and there are very few people we would trust. And Kevin Bales is one of those people. Kevin Bales, in addition to being a professor at Georgia State University, a prolific performer, arranger, sideman, headliner, he is highly involved in the Rialto Youth Orchestra, raising an entire new generation of jazz performers. And he also happens to be the person who has played on this stage more than anyone. And we are so happy and honored to have him. Tonight, he does something highly unusual. He comes to the stage without any preconceived notions of what he's going to play. I know. For some people, that would not work out well. But for him, I trust him. It's going to be fabulous. So he is going to allow the wind and the vibe and the energy to take him where he wants to go. And he's taking along with him some great players from the Mike Beal Band. We have Jack Jones on drums. And from Branford Marcellus's band and other places, we have Delbert Felix on upright bass. And we are introducing tonight to the Velvet Note audiences a new singer. She is phenomenal. I spent so much time listening to her on YouTube, and I said, where you been all my life? Where you been? And that's Roberta Setsu. So put your hands together for the Kevin Bales Trio featuring Roberta Setsu!
Hello, everybody. Please welcome to the stage, on bass, one of my all-time favorite musicians. I don't say that lightly. The very spiritual and masterful musician, Delbert Felix. I met Jack Jones here in Atlanta. Every time I hear him, he's amazing. And this is no slight on him, but originally this gig was going to feature a drummer from South Carolina named Edwin Hamilton. And just a few days ago, he came down with COVID. He's okay, but he doesn't want to, you know, subject any of us. So I called Jack at the last minute. He's here and ready, which is beautiful. He's an amazing drummer. I can't wait for you to hear him. And we're going to do something I think is brave and relevant, and something my mentors did. We're going to play this music with no preparation. No, we have no set list. They don't know what I'm going to play. We're going to get up here and have a purely authentic and naked expression and experience in front of you. So please don't judge us. I think it's great fun. I can't think of two better people to do this. And then later we'll be joined by Roberta Setsu. So with that in mind, I'm going to sit at the piano, and the first song that comes to mind, I'm just going to start something, okay? And I'll tell you what it is later, if you don't recognize it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Everyone, let's welcome to the stage Miss Roberta Setsu.
Thank you so much. It's so good to be back. Thank you, Kevin, for having me. It seems like yesterday, but it's been 6 months ago. My last concert actually was my album debut of my album co-produced by Kevin. And so, super nice to be here, be back.
It's great. She was called at last minute for this too, which is just so great.
Yeah, I'm always up for improvisation and for all the crazy things that Kevin has in mind. So.
It's not mine. I just let the music happen. Again, let's hear it for Delbert Felix and Jack Jones. How about this is a positive song. I love it so much. Sunny Side of the Street. Is that good?
Let's do it.
What key do you do it in?
C minor.
Okay.
Thank you.
Alberta.
Thank you. What's next?
So how many of you in here are in love? That's a good showing. How many of you are divorced? You know, you said not currently. Oh my gosh. I love this song so much. It can mean something for both sides of that equation. It's by this great songwriter, Ray DePaul. It's called You Don't Know What Love Is. No. That sounds negative by itself. It could be they just broke up with you and you're bitter, but it could also mean like you finally found true love. My own mother, she found true love at the age of 78. I love this guy, he's great. They're 88 now, but that's an amazing thing. And I love the way Roberta sings ballads. I've never done this song with you before.
Yeah.
So that's exciting. I think you said D minor?
I usually do it in D minor.
Okay, all right. So when you hear it, you take either side of the story, which one appeals to you. Here we go.
I'm in a bad mood, so now I'm joking.
Can we move back a little bit? It's the saddest of all keys, they say.
Of course. That's my specialty.
Thank you. Thank you.
Love will not die, we'll keep it away. Now, the mountain scars will bow. recognizes peace.
Thank you.
Everyone. Let's hear it again from Roberta Setsu. You're not done. On bass, from the jazz capital of the world, Beaufort, South Carolina, Mr. Delbert Felix. And let's hear it for the wonderful Jack Jones, effortlessly doing everything. Hey, do you sing Kansas City? Do you sing Kansas City?
I don't know.
A blue, do you sing a blues?
Yeah.
A blues blues, a groove blues.
Let's do whatever.
You're gonna make it up. We're gonna do this.
Let's do that.
This is called Centerpiece by Harry Sweets Edison. It's the last song for the set. Thank you all for being here. Hope you are all healthy and safe.
Thank you.
Jack Jones. Thank you for coming. Travel safely. We will be back in 5 jazz minutes for a second set. Thanks again. Be safe.
Thank you.
guys are going to be doing the clapping for you. They're practicing right now. They're warming up. I just want to tell you briefly that the Velvet Note is a place where you can see and hear world-class musicians in a setting that's as intimate and as comfortable as your living room. We give you a chance to get to know the musicians and to hear the music the way that it was meant to be heard. The Velvet Note's a listening room. We had our acoustics designed by a protege of the Hollywood director George Lucas under his guidance to be the highest quality unenhanced sound available today. And you're going to be really glad that we did that because we have a special show for you tonight. Kevin Bales is the person who has performed on the stage more than anyone else in our 8-year history. And we're so happy to have him here tonight doing something called the Freedom Trio. And what that means is that he gets on stage with his band, he has no predisposition about what he's going to play, and he just lets it rip. He goes where the energy leads him. And for some people, that would be scary. But for Kevin Bales, I totally trust him, and it's going to be a fantastic show. Totally different than the first set tonight, just for you. He is going to also introduce us to a singer whose voice I've been listening to on YouTube for the last week. And I played her through my headset in the morning when I went out for my run, and I played her right before I went to sleep. And I said, girl, where you been all my life? And that is Roberta Setsu. She's sitting right here. Give her a hand. So sit back and relax, enjoy. He's got Jack Jones with him on drums. Jack's from Mike Beale's band. And he has a great Delbert Felix from Branford Marsalis' band on upright acoustic bass. And so you guys ready to rock? Ready to jazz? Ready to do it? I need you to do your share of clapping and some clapping for the people out there, okay? You ready? Put your hands together for the Freedom Trio, starring Kevin Bales!
All right, I have to say this quite briefly. Oh, she already ran back because she's cooking food. She's a chef, which is amazing. But COVID time is tough for musicians. And my whole life, I've never experienced anything like this. And the fact, the way the Velvet Note has been treating this situation is so beautiful. Open, but safe. And I just want to thank, she's in back, she's not here, I'm gonna do it again when she's here. But I just want to thank Tamara Fuller for everything that she does for the music community. Yeah. Here. And I never realized so deeply until this time now, how much I need to perform music in front of people. Because we all connect, and it's great. So thank you for coming out here tonight. All right. Delbert Felix is one of the very greatest bass players in the world, and he happens to live in Atlanta. I'm very lucky he's here to play with me. Let's hear it for him, please. Jack Jones is the best drummer on the stage. I have heard like 100 of my mentors say that dumb joke. Jack Jones is actually one of the very best drummers I've ever known. He plays so open and free, and he got hired for this at the very last minute. Once more, I know you clap once, just do it again for me. Thank you. Sing over here is the wonderful songstress from Italy, Sardinia to be specifically, Miss Roberta Setsu. That's beautiful. So we're doing something that I think is very authentic jazz, but people don't always know that we're doing it, I want to tell you. We have no agenda. We don't have a song list. We have not rehearsed. We are going to pick songs that we already know and on the spot create something new with it that has never happened before. This first song, which I picked, I'm going to tell him the name of the song, is going to feature the wonderful Jack Jones, best drummer on stage. This is a Thelonious Monk song called The Bimsha Swing. We'll be right back. just killing it. So I love this next song. We don't know who wrote it. The Animals covered it in the 60s. I'm not gonna play that version. And I don't sing, but I know every lyric. This is a song called House of the Rising Sun. Thank you.
Thank you.
Like that? That was great for me. The very, very first time I went to New York as a musician, I'm being paid very little. I'm staying in this like horrible hostel down in Greenwich Village. But the great musician Wynton Marsalis, who's one of the reasons I play music, had a show, a free show at a church in Harlem. Now, if you know New York, that's really far away from Greenwich Village, but it's fine, I'm all ready to go. But I was new to the city. Taxi was gonna be like $30, which is a lot back then, but that's how far it was. So I'm gonna take the subway. I haven't ridden the subway much, so I go to the subway station, and I walk up to the little toll booth, and I say to them, hey, how do I get to this address in Harlem? And they literally say, you take the A train all the way to Harlem. I did not realize that's where the song came from. I really thought it meant take A train. I didn't know. A train, 9 train, you know, it's one of these two things. Okay, this next song we're gonna play, I'm gonna bring up Roberta Setsu for this. It's special to me. We were talking about this earlier. I'm pretty sure the very first jazz I ever heard was from a TV show. I didn't know it was jazz. And it's profoundly influenced me. There's a TV show that was syndicated all around the country on PBS. It was called Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. You're laughing, but check this out. Fred Rogers, Mr. Rogers, he had a master's degree in music composition. He wrote every song on the show, including 13 operas, which is something else. Yeah. I didn't know this about him until maybe the last 10 years, and he didn't just write songs, he was very serious about it. And he had this very strong feeling that when he wrote songs for the show, that they should not only be good for children, but he knew the adults were watching too.
So he had this unique way of writing songs that were right for not only children and adults, but also for musicians, because he loved them. It's amazing. So we're going to do one of my favorite songs of him. It's not famous. This is a song of his called I Like to Take My Time. And if you are a musician nerd, it's got some like music theory in it that's unusually risk-taking. He changes keys, and then when you're supposed to change back, he doesn't. He literally takes his time to get back to the original key. And Roberta's so nice to learn this song, so I'm going to present to you, with no rehearsal, Mr. Rogers, I Like to Take My Time.
Check him out, Tony. He's great.
I actually never heard it, you know, before Kevin introduced it to me. I never heard about Mr. Rogers because it didn't arrive. Yeah, because it didn't arrive to Italy, and I wish it did, because then I loved his show. Gosh, we would have learned so many things.
Something else. Here we go.
Thank you.
that is?
Juice.
Yeah, with what was that?
Soda.
Right. Yes. Let's keep it PG-13. Close to the side.
forever and a day. And love will not die, we'll keep it away. And the moon and stars will fly, happiness will last.
Song by Ray DePaul, great Broadway writer. This is called You Don't Know What Love Is. And it can mean many things. Could be anguish, could be deep love, your choice. But I love, we did it last set. I don't usually repeat songs, but it was so much fun. I want to do it again.
Let's do it.
What key was it? I don't remember.
It was D minor.
I got you. Thank you.
Because it changed my keys a lot.
No, I just don't remember.
Of reminiscing. don't know how hearts burn for love. They cannot live yet, never die. Thank you.
Song, I love it. Oh my God, I love Vampanella song that long, and my man here started clapping. You made me so happy, man. Seriously, this is why I miss so much from COVID, is being able to play. The music is so much better when everyone is part of it. Thank you all so much for being here. Thank you to Tamara Ford. I just saw her run through here. She's probably running to get some orange juice. I don't know. Let's hear it again for Delbert Felix. And I don't know how much non-musicians care or see this, but that last chord progression that we did all over and over, he put the stink on it. You're the one who put that G. I was like, that's the best thing. I was like, yeah, this is it. I was like, we're going to keep three. It was your fault. It was great. Okay, so what's next? Let's do one of your originals.
Okay,
let's do Come As You Are.
Okay.
Come As You Are. We wrote this song together. It's a beautiful experience. I didn't say this last time. I should have. We have a brand new CD that came out basically like March, first week of March. Worst time. We did one release for it. But I'm proud of it. We wrote a bunch of the songs together. She wrote most of them. Great band on the record. It's your first album, right?
Yes, we co-produce it, and I can't say how lucky I am to have Kevin as a mentor. I feel like every time he plays,
She's equal on stage, right? She's bringing it. But now forgive me, they're for sale here. if listen, it's a great record. I'm proud of it. And yeah, it is. It's special. She's got a special message. That's why I jumped aboard. And I love writing songs with someone who's open. This is probably my favorite song on the record. It's not easy. And it's unlike other songs I've ever heard, and the lyrics are beautiful. This is called Come As You Are.
Thank you.
And Siri. seriously, one of my favorite musicians who's ever lived. I don't say this lightly. I'm so honored you were here doing all this stuff, Mr. Delbert Felix. Yes. VelvetNote.com, including our Earth, Wind, and Fire annual tribute. Takes place over Labor Day, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Yeah. And next weekend, Saturday and Sunday, we have Mercy Myra. They say that she is the Jennifer Lopez of Kenya. Right here at the Velvet Note. So, get those tickets. It's going to be a fun, fun show. But one, you know, I just have to say, was I right about Roberta or what?
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you.
This is what we love to do, which is to bring you closer to artists who inspire you, closer to each other, and closer to the song. It's in your heart. Come and see us again. Good night.
Good night. Good night.